You want to form a band? You came to the right person. Let's do it.
Yeah. Man, Bobby, I think this is a great idea.
You said you want to meet girls. What better way than to be in a band?
All right, baby, this is Wolfman Jack. Listen up. Wolfman friend Earl, starting a brand new band. All listeners between the ages of 10 and 14. You want to try out for the band? You come down to WBLZ before the moon is full.
Man, do you think anyone will show up to the audition?
Okay, let's start these auditions. Who's first?
Papa was a rolling stone. And he let his hat was his home.
And when he died...
Papa was a rolling stone.
And when he died... Cause I killed him! Die! Papa die! Papa die! Papa die!
And when he died,
Bobby and Earl,
when he left us, was alone. I'm talking only. I mean A-N-E.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Bobby, how many times have I told you to leave your father's radio alone?
Turn on the radio and give me that rhythm and blues. That's all I want from you. Whenever I hear a Motown groove, I just wanna stand up and sing. I close my eyes and I'm in ecstasy when I turn on my radio. Ooh, my body moves, I get into the groove, and all I wanna do is sing the melody, yeah. Turn on the radio, baby, that's rhythm and blues. That's all I want from you, so turn it on, baby, that's rhythm and blues.
Everybody, put your hands together for Mark, Smoot, Vince, and Daryl, a.k.a. the boys next door!
Hey, boy, that name is stupid. Who thought of that?
I did.
Oh, man, that name is stupid.
Okay, now that we have us a band, when do we meet the women? I think I got mine picked out. Yo, home Skilly.
Your fly's open. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Who are they?
This is Smooth, Vince, and Mark. We are the boys next door.
Next door to where?
Miss Washington? Boys Next Door, that's the name of their new group.
I knew that. I'm down. I guess we have singing talent in the family. When I was your age, my girlfriends and I, we formed this little group called the Motor Rats. You should have heard us sing "He's So Fine." Doodle-lang, doodle-lang, doodle-lang. Doodle-lang, doodle-lang. I sang Becca. Doodle-lang, doodle-lang. Hey, why are we chilling? First thing we gotta decide is what to wear to the MTV Awards.
Yeah. No, the first thing we gotta do is get a manager.
How about Bobby?
Yeah,
Bobby. Oh, no, I couldn't possibly.
Yeah,
Bobby. Now, wait a minute. You gonna put your career in his hands? I mean, Take a look around. There's a brother that knows the music, knows the business. He's hip. He's happening, and he's got a wealth of experience for you little dudes to draw upon.
You're right. Don, you want to manage the guys?
Me?
Him? You want Father Time when you can have me?
I think it's a great idea, Don.
Father Time?
I mean, after all, you were in the Four Tops.
It was the Five Tops, and I was the fifth. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I'm too busy.
Yeah, that's right. He's way too busy.
But Don has the professionalism, the experience. I mean, it wouldn't be fair if you didn't share your talent, that precious gift. Oh.
Well, I'm not that busy.
Yeah!
Okay. But look, we got to get started right away. If you want to make it, you got to practice, focus, and think about nothing else but your music. Yeah. Let me tell you about when I first started. The year was 1962.
My God, how old are you?
Where's Don? He promised me a ride home.
He just left with the guys. He's gonna manage their band.
What? Don is gonna manage the group? Whose bright idea was that?
Let me give you a hint. He's the only person in this room that ain't eligible for the United Negro College Fund.
So this was your idea? You should have never done that.
You see, Bobby, you can't get Don back into music again. When he quit the Four Tops, it was a very painful time for him. He bounced around and his solo career didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, and nobody wanted to buy his one album, Abraham, Martin, and Don.
It wasn't until my Jesse gave him this job that he got his life going in a new direction.
Well, maybe this time it'll be different. I mean, Four Tops, all that stuff was just years ago. Then this is just Earl and a bunch of kids.
Well, maybe he's right.
Maybe he's wrong. You shouldn't have gone dredging up the past.
Are you happy now?
Oh, I'm...
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. I was just trying to help little Dorothy. Look at the cycles under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
5, 6, 7, 8.
And you were saying something loud.
No. Come on. We've been over this 100 times. You gotta pick up your feet. Pick up your feet. Come on, again. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, man. Can we go home now? My feet hurt. I'm tired. And I miss my slinky.
Could we be pros, please?
Come on, Don. We're tired.
Tired? Let me tell you a little story.
Oh, man.
The year was 1963. The place, Harrisburg, PA. The rain had turned to hail. All of the top acts were pulling out, and the Temptations were packing up. Little Richard, he was in a tizzy. But the Five Tops, we went on, even though we were soaked. The audience was getting ready to go home. But when we started to sing Reach Out, I'll Be There, they were so moved, they called us back for 3 encores. So don't you tell me about being tired.
Can I tell you about being hungry?
Hungry? The year was 1964.
Oh, yes. Hey, guys, how's it going? Yeah,
meep. Can you see that we're in the middle of a rehearsal here?
Oh, my. It's the Wicked Witch of the West! Run, Toto, run! Oh, he got away! He got away! Hey, guys, I met some fans outside. Allison, Emmy, and Liza, come on down!
Eddie! You were wondering, can we watch you rehearse?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, come on. This is a closed rehearsal. Right this way, ladies. Come on. Come on, don't worry. I've got some autographed pictures up on the kitchen table.
Do you have one of Earl?
No, they're of me.
All right. Is he dedicated or what?
We hate him.
Yeah, he works 9 hours a day, never lets us take a break, and bores us with all those dumb stories. Who cares what happened before 1979?
You know, Bobby, we do the staff fun and meet girls. And when it finally happens, Don just throws them out.
I say we fire them.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa. No, 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 no. If you fire Don, you're going to break his heart.
You know, you're absolutely right. You fire him.
All right, again. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hey, where's everybody going? Nobody said we were done.
All right, we'll pick it up tomorrow. And don't forget to clock out.
I haven't had this much fun in 30 years. And I've got you to thank for it.
Oh, Don.
No, really, really, Don. Really, man, look, I mean it. I mean, I can take these kids to the top. It takes me back to when I first started. I mean, all the rehearsing and the long hours and that camaraderie. The year was 1961. It was... Oh, Bobby, I'm sorry. Was there something you wanted to tell me?
Tell you. Yeah, did anybody ever tell you that you used to look like Isaac from The Love Boat?
They want you to fire Don?
I knew it. I knew no good would come of it. Luring that poor man back into the music. Now listen, Bobby. You got Don into this. You're gonna have to be the one to tell him.
Oh, but don't worry, Bobby. No matter what happens, we're here to back you up.
Oh, yeah, that goes without saying.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Bubble Smokey. Good morning. Isn't this a beautiful day?
Is that my phone? No, that's not me.
Wait until rehearsal tonight. I've got a surprise for the boys. Isn't this dope?
Don, there's something I really need to say to you.
Yeah?
Yeah. Remember last night when I told you the boys left early because they were tired?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't tell you who they were tired of.
Oh?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not good at this. Don, the guys want you out.
What?
I tried to talk to them. I did. I, you know how kids are, you know? They just want everything to be fun and...
Well, it is fun. I'm having fun. Do you think that I would drive those kids 24 hours a day if it wasn't fun? So it's final?
I'm sorry. I know this has really got to hurt you.
It's okay, Bobby. I'm okay. I just got to run this... dopey suit back down to the tailor.
Oh, Don.
No, 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 really. Really, I mean, actually, this couldn't come at a better time. You know, I mean, I'm swamped with work. I haven't spent a moment with my wife. And if I miss one more Melrose Place, I'll never catch up.
Is Don here yet?
The love man hasn't seen him. Now, if you will excuse him, the love man would like to reproduce.
Yes, I'm sorry, but Don just isn't here. Yes, I know that you've been leaving messages for 2 days. It's Lenny, owner of Tyrone's Tuxedo Town. He wants to hear Don's commercial. I can't put him off any longer. Yes, one moment, please.
Hey, Lenny, this is Jack Nicholson. Yeah, when my good friend Don Phillips told me that you needed a spokesman for Tyrone's Tuxedo Town, I said, wait till they get a load of me. Gotta go. Nurse Ratchet's here.
Still no Don?
Listen, I feel terrible about this. I mean, at least if I knew where he was, I could talk to him.
Well, so could I. I mean, he's missing sponsor meetings. His wife said he came home late last night and left early this morning. Mm-hmm. I'm starting to get worried.
The love man finds himself becoming frantic. The love man suggests we form a love posse.
Well, actually, that's not a bad thought. We could split up and check out some of Don's favorite hangouts.
Great idea! Yeah!
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that might be. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Hey, Lou, another tuna roll. Make it a double.
You've been here for 2 days. Don't sing, don't smile, just keep sucking down the sushi. If it's answers you're looking for, you are not going to find them in raw fish.
You're a wise and sensitive man.
Ah! Bobby, you crazy, man. Now, what would Don be doing in a karaoke bar?
Isn't that him?
I told you he would be here.
Gilligan, my boy, the important thing is that we found him. Now, let's get Don off this crummy island.
Left a good job in the city. Working for the band every night and day. But I never lost a man in the sleeping. What about the way things might have been? Lord, big wheel will keep on turning. Oh,
look who's here. It's Don.
Oh, joy.
I'm really sorry about this. I mean, I thought it would be great to get you back into music. I didn't know all this was going to happen.
Yeah, Don. Anyway, they're just a bunch of kids.
You two just don't get it.
Sure we do. All this is just dragging up a lot of bad stuff for you.
Yeah, I mean, like, when you quit the Four Tops because they wouldn't make you lead singer. I mean, so what? They went on to become rich and famous and sold millions of albums and sung before the Queen and...
Don, look, you're being way too rough on yourself. I mean, not many people would have the courage and the creative conviction to walk out on a group like the Five Tops.
Yeah.
And stand up to a great singer like Levi Stubbs.
Look, oh. I didn't have courage and I didn't have conviction and I didn't quit the Four Tops. They fired me just like those kids did.
What?
I wasn't good enough. The Tops kicked me out. And you know what the worst part of it was? They were right. Let's just face it, guys, I'm a loser.
No, how can you say that? I mean, instead of thinking about yourself as a loser, why don't you think about how lucky you are? Man, you got a great job, you got friends.
Yeah, you got a lot of people that care about you.
Yeah.
I got nothing.
You got 2 shrimp left?
Just leave me alone, okay?
Well, you sure handled that well.
Well, it's not over yet. I got an idea.
I don't want to hear no more of your stupid ideas, Bobby.
Okay.
Okay, I listen to one more of your stupid ideas. Hold on!
I got you, babe.
I got you, babe. I got you, babe.
Say, buddy, won't you get on up there and belt one out?
Thanks, Tex. I don't sing.
Say, weren't you,
Yeah. I used to be one of the Five Tops.
No, weren't you in here yesterday?
Ladies and gentlemen, this next song is for a very special friend of mine. And he knows who he is. Don Phillips! Now we
can feel that you can't go on, because all of your hope is gone, and your life is filled with much confusion, until happiness is just an illusion,
and your world around is tumbling down. The love man says,
reach out,
reach out, God.
Friday night on an all-new roundtable, Caitlin plays a seductive card game where winner takes all. But will her game of sexual intrigue backfire? NBC Friday. Coming up next, Norm thinks he's died and gone to beer heaven on an all-new Cheers.